where the Rio Grande is flowing and the stars are shining bright. We walked along the river on a quiet summer night. She said, if you remember, we parted long ago. I promised to come back again and not to leave her so. She's the sweetest rose of color this fellow ever knew. Her eyes are bright as diamonds, they sparkle like the dew. You may talk about your dearest maids and sang up Rosalie, but the yellow rose of Texas beats the bells of Tennessee. Oh, I'm going back to find her, for my heart is full of woe. We'll sing the songs together we sang so long ago. I'll pick the banjo gaily and sing the songs of yore, and the yellow rose of Texas shall be mine forevermore. She's the sweetest rose of color this fellow ever knew. Her eyes are bright as diamonds, they sparkle like the dew. You may talk about your dearest maids and sing of Rosalie, but the yellow rose of Texas beats the bells of Tennessee.
Gene Autry with the Yellow Rose of Texas. Now, here is a very, very famous lady. This is Dame Vera Lynn, the original Forces sweetheart, and this is We'll Meet Again.
We'll meet again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. So will you please say hello to the folks that I know, tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song. Again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.
Yeah.
Here on, and we'll meet again. Right now, here's the Count Basie Trio and Lady Be Good. Goombazy Trio and Old Lady Be Good. Right, folks, listen up and listen carefully. If you get a telephone call from a Glasgow telephone number, and the number is 01415703200, totally ignore it. It is a scam. My wife has just got that in on her mobile, and I've just phoned the company and they won't tell me who they are. So, word of warning. When I get a chance, I'll put it on to VRN Facebook page. But as it stands, the telephone number 01415703200. Do not answer it. It is a scam and they're only there trying to make money out of you. Or it might come up 00141 570 3200. The call originates in the United States of America. But as I say, I'll put this up on the VRN's Facebook page a little bit later. Right now, back to business. Here we go with episode 15 of the Glenmidden Chronicles.
It's now 3 days into the Royal Voyage for the MV Glenmidden, and all seems to have been going fine. There have been some hiccups when Prince Philip asked Maggie for an extra couple of dumplings at dinner time, and she slapped him. Also, Charles has been pining for Camilla, who is back home in the kitchens at Highgrove, making biscuits for the Duchy to offset the credit crunch. Times are hard. Charles is now down to his last two Austin Martins and Bentley. The ship is heading towards the small isles, and the Queen has summoned the captain to her cabin.
So, Captain Horatio Hornblower?
McNelson, ma'am.
Whatever. Anyway, Captain, one believes we're heading for the small islands.
Muck, Your Majesty.
Beg pardon?
Muck. We're heading for muck, ma'am.
We don't have to head for it. There's enough of it around here to last one's lifetime.
No, not Mucky Muck. The island of Muck, ma'am.
Oh, one sees. One was making a jest. One is not amused. Anyway, when we arrive at the small islands, one is very keen to see a basking shark. One expects that will not be too much trouble for you, Captain.
Oh, good heavens, no. No trouble at all. One will see to it that one sees one when one is there. Was that all, ma'am?
No. One has noticed that rather common female in the galley has been, oh, how do the commoners put it? Flirting. Yes, flirting with my husband. One expects that sort of behaviour to stop as from today. However, should my husband give her any encouragement, then one demands to be informed in order that I can cut off his per diem.
Well, I shall inform Your Majesty when we arrive at Muck, and perhaps you would like to join us on the observation deck in order to take a good look at the basking sharks. Say drink is at 7?
Captain now makes his way to the cafeteria to inform Maggie of Her Majesty's request, and also to ask Scotty about the chances of seeing a basking shark when they arrive at Muck.
You have no chance at this time of the year. These sharks are devious little baskings. They'll not come out in this weather.
Scotty, I don't think it was a request. I have an annus horribilis that it was a demand. And she doesn't see a basking shark, then our lives will be untenable.
If I knew what that meant, I might be a bit more sympathetic.
Untenable, Scotty. It means we wouldn't be able to put up any defence for not being able to supply Her Majesty with what she wants.
All right, we'll just have to make sure that there's a basking shark floating